Come on, please be home. Oh, tons of bait in there. Oh. Oh, there's one on that. Look at the size of him. Oh, my, oh, Jesus. He's really big. He's really, really big. I was gonna sleep on the boat, so much easier. That boat's just built for it, but the only thing it can't help you with is rain, being a center console. So I thought I'd be smart for once and just bring the swag, and I'll sit up on the island here, and I won't need it. I've got it. And it's a tricky one, this one, because it's a great island. This one's called Score. For I encourage you, if you get a chance, come out and spend a couple of nights here. It's absolutely beautiful. It's on the southern part of the Whitsundays, off Mackay. Beauty in that is, it's not full of bloody rubbos and day tours with backpackers all over the joint. In fact, got it to myself, just me and Bonnie. Very nice. It's got basic facilities. We've got like a bit of a picnic table and a dunny. Greg from Bonito put me onto this joint. Bloody good tip. I'm gonna set up close to the... I'll have dinner and everything on the boat. I'll just set, just mainly set this up just in case it does rain. And look at this. It's all here for you, isn't it? No one else here. I don't think that dunny's a Taj Mahal. It's better than a shovel, though. Ew. Thanks, Greg, for the tip. There's no one here. I'm so sitting up right here. Look at this. Undercover. Everything. Oh, this is going rocks. Reynolds. Hey, what do you do? You can even stand up if you want. We'll sit here. Right. Boat review. It has been a long time coming. A lot of people have been writing to me saying, when are you doing a rundown on the boat? Like I said, no boat can be given a review until you spend some time in it, in all different sea conditions. So, I think I'm in a position now to give you guys a full and honest appraisal of this boat. If you follow my channel for a while, you know, one, I love my center consoles. Brad hates them, I love them. I just think they're the best fishing platform. If you're serious about fishing, you can't beat a center console. Two, I love Bonito boats. Many reasons for that. I used to own a 560. Bonito 560, I caught everything in that from bloody snapper in close in 10 metres, out to Blue Marlin on the shelf. Absolute gun little boat. And then I wanted to upsize a little bit. Mrs. and I were going to come up and spend some time up here in Queensland, so I had a specific boat in mind, or type of boat in mind that I wanted. It had a couple of criteria that it had to tick off for me. So originally I had spoken to the Adam at Bonito and I had my heart set on Bonito 660, which is a behemoth of a boat. Absolutely beautiful hull. Been out in Greg's one up here in Mackay. Fantastic. But probably a little bit too big for what I really needed in hindsight. But I actually went up to the factory to check out some of the 660 hulls and the first ever 620 was sitting in the doorway. And it's like when you walked into a nightclub and your actual wife's way out the back where the 660s were, there's a mad sort right at the front door. The first ever 620 was right at the front door and I just fell straight in love and that was it for me. Said to Adam, cancel the 660. I want one of these. And I have not regretted that decision. This boat is perfect and I'll explain to you why for me. So firstly, background. Love my center consoles. you follow the channel, you know I just love fishing. So, but up here I wanted to do some more long range work. So I needed a boat built specifically for that. I wanted, obviously, long range fuel tank. So this model here has got a 380 litre tank in it. Gives me a range of conservatively about 500 kilometres. And you'll see tomorrow, which will be the next episode, I'm doing a hell mission out the reef, and I'll show you the kilometres I do on one tank. So this is the Bonito 620. When you have a look at this boat on the trailer, you'll see there's some hallmarks there from the old Haynes V19R, which was, yeah, a classic hull. Famous to this day for very good reasons in that it was a sensational ride. I was blown away by the ride on this one, the handling of it, but the smoothness of the ride is something else. Very hard to explain to you when you're doing a boat review, but I have got some footage, which I'll throw up now, of this boat in pretty gnarly seas, and its spray deflection is best I've ever seen in a centre console. And I have actually owned a Haynes before, had a 445F, which is a great little boat, but this thing is next level for that. So it's the Bonito 620. They had now two configurations for this particular hull. They've got the centre console and they've got the Express, which is like a front drive thing, if that's more your thing. Like I said, I love the centre console. Mine's, let's do the outside first. So you'll see, hopefully you can just see, there's almost a Carolina flare there. Probably half Carolina, I'd say. But that is responsible for that spray deflection that I was talking about. As we come down the back here, I've got the transom steps on my model, which I encourage you to get. I've got the Lenco trip tabs underneath. I've got a 3-in-1 transducer under there, and I've also got a 1 kilowatt through hole, which I'll show you when we get inside. I love the Suzis. I won't get into debates over motors, but I had a Suzuki on the last Bonito. Never let me down. This is the 200 I've got. This was fitted by AMC, Australian Marine Centre, just south of Brisbane there. The blokes there were really, really helpful. They did it in a hurry for me. Their follow-up after sale service was second to none. Rod, I think, is the bloke there that I spoke to. He was happy to field any questions I had because I'm pretty stupid with motors and stuff like that. So they were great. So to the boys at AMC, thank you very much. I'll put their link below. But great servers, great install. I've had no dramas with that motor whatsoever. It's been great. Again, I got Adam to fit me with a little ladder here because I, again, this boat is built for a specific purpose, and that is a lot of island runs. And a lot of times when the missus comes with me, she's bloody open, so we need to get that ladder on the back, which is really good. I'll show you how that works. Folds out. Away you go. Got me in there. And what I might do is put a little handle in here at some point. Or in there, something like just a little grab whip handle so I can use it to get up. Like so. So, boat review. What are we going to do? Let's start at the front and I'll just walk you through this puppy. Oh, I like it. Well, I love it actually. Right, so we're inside now. We'll start at the front and we'll just walk back through the features on this boat and why I love it. First of all, you Bonito bowsprit. That did a lovely little engraving there. That comes with all Bonitos. Just that little signature touch, which I like. Great big anchor well on this. So if you have a look in there, plenty of room for a drum winch if you want to go that way. Big flat surface there, but big deep anchor well. Plenty of room in there for rope, chain, whatever. All the Bonitos come with a electric motor pad. I haven't put electric on this. You'll see from the channel that I do a lot of drift fishing, so I haven't had that need yet, but certainly it's there if you want that feature. Righto, casting. So when I say I wanted this boat built for a specific purpose, this is one of the most important things that I wanted, was a really big extended cast deck, which Adam accommodated for me. And it is almost 2 meters back. So the reason behind that is one, I think when you're island fishing and reef fishing, especially doing top water, you want that big dance floor. You want that big area up there that you can cast and you know, you're free of any obstacles. Casting out of the back of boats, front drives, when you want to throw stick baits all day, I just don't think it's the best setup for it. Each their own obviously, but yeah, there's so much room here. But the good thing about here is also such wide gunnels, you know. So This is pretty much a walk around boat. It's so thick, I can walk around right out the back. We'll get the transom in a minute. But you'll see on my vids, you know, I spend most of my time casting over here, which is great. So you've got, you know, full exposure to wherever you're in Australia lives. So cast deck, it's big. One for the fishing purpose of it, and two for storage. One thing I know about center consoles is they can suffer from a lack of storage. Not so in this boat, because I've got this extended cast deck, so I've got a huge storage area under there, which I'm just putting all safety gear and stuff in there for now. A little bit of emergency fuel. And this, I'll just open it quickly. This thing is massive. It's actually an ice box. So it's 50 mil insulated, fully insulated ice box. It's just giant. It's a mackerel box, really. I've got 10 bags of ice in there at the moment. I've got all my food. None of that ice has actually melted yet. It's been in there for 4 hours so far. So that's fantastic. We'll see how that holds ice overnight. But that is, if you're not using that for fish, then wife and I have had tents in there, cabanas, two like fold out chairs, all of our cooking stuff, everything is all packed away. You're doing a 200 kilometer run somewhere, you don't want stuff around your feet. That gets rid of it for you. And if you're not doing that kind of stuff with your missus or your family or what have you, you want to go out fishing, chuck it full of ice like I've done on this session, load her up, and you got some fish. So, third reason behind the cast deck is, if you look back to one of my episodes when I slept out in the reef by myself, I actually put in a single blow-up mattress here, and it fits the whole length of here, so it doubles as a bed, triples as a bed. One is a casting area, two is great for storage, and three, I had it built like this for a bed as well. Yeah, one other thing about the Bonitos, which I love, and I'm going to bitch about other boats, but it is a flaw that I see on a lot of boats, especially ones that are kind of trendy at the moment. Won't mention any names, but this is critical. You see, my feet can go right up under here, and I can actually put my shins up here, my calves, like this, all the way around. All the way around this boat, basically. I reckon if you're gonna be going out to sea and you are gonna be in seas where the boat's gonna be pitching and rolling a fair bit, this is vital. If you wanna stand up here and cast lures, you need to get your feet under there so you can brace yourself. The boats that have the inside going all the way straight down to the floor, like that, you can't get your toes to there. You're basically doing this, you're like a dog on liner. So one of the features I love about this boat is my ability to get my toes right up under there. And further down, it's like getting the thighs right up under there and hooking in, and you've got some good stability. You can cast all day, doesn't matter what the ocean throws at you, you're safe. Righto, I'm in here, your little story chat. And one of the boys at Bonito, Graham Brake, he did all the wiring here, done a smicko job, all inline fuses. But if you want to access your wiring internally, you come in through this hatch. So this is like I said, it's an all new hull. So this is not based off the 560, it's not based off the 660. Adam built this hull from the ground up. So it's got basically the 560 center console, which has been widened, so it's like two of them were joined together, which makes it a beast of a console, which is what you want. Like I said, really wide gunnels, so you can walk all the way around this boat if you want to. When we get down to the transom, it's a serious transom. You can fish off the back on top of that, like you can at the front. Side pockets, all glassed in. Yeah, you can stand on these every day of the week, have a disco on them, no worries, it's not gonna break. Console, here we go. So I opted for this model of the console, and I think it's fantastic. This is my design placement here. I didn't put this big sim rod on this side because I want to put some more electronics up there, and I also like just being able to drive here and then being able to work my electronics with the other hand. Trim tabs, like I said, I didn't go fly by wire, I went traditional for the motor, drains wired up, everything, bilge pump, auto bilge pump, everything, which I think is also vital if you're camping out on islands at night and you get big torrential downpours. You want to make sure that you've got an auto bilge to kick in. So, and then inside the console, hopefully you can see, you got two shells, these are dry. I can attest to that. I've got my drone every in and out. I put my Blue Eddy in there, a charger, and dry clothes. But I wouldn't do that evil had doubts about everything staying dry. So I've just got my real important stuff in there and my safety gear. So moving back, just quickly, I've got 6 rod holders, 3 on each side. Got recessed cleats here for tying off. They're all pretty standard features on Bonitos. This thing here, this is wicked. This is a bench seat. It's bloody good. Takes up a bit of space, I will grant you that. But for again, for what I want, it's absolutely perfect because it's so comfortable to drive on. Yeah, Mrs. and I can sit here all day and just drive. Yeah, get the autopilot, which is my foot, stick that on the wheel, and you just fang it and drive all day. Really, really comfortable. Probably a little bit close if you want to sort of, you know, move around and get something out of the console, but you know, everything's a trade-off. You want that comfort when you're driving. I think that's primary concern. And if you have this too far back, you're sort of, you know, leaning like this when you want to drive, which I think is a bit awkward. But here, I can sit like this all day, drive along. Beautiful. But the big thing about this seat, which I love, and you can configure this again any way you want, but she's got mega storage in that. And this is dry too. I've got all my camera gear in there, more bedding for tonight, and all my lures and stuff. So I wanted to make sure that is a completely dry compartment before I put that sort of stuff in there, because once you get rust in, just kills it, eh? Transom. Like I said, this is a serious transom. Again, the beauty of it is this. You just stand here and cast all day from the back. So you're fishing two blokes. Two up the front, one or two down the back if you want to. You know, I don't like fishing a lot of blokes in the boat, but certainly be out here with a mate. One guy can fish down the back here, just standing like this. And you've got so much room because it's a really wide, stable feeling transom. You can run to this side, you know, fish pop up over there and bang, chuck your lures out. Run up the front if you want, it's great. It is great. It looks good and it's really effective for, particularly for your top water fishing. Okay, so just looking further at the transom, more storage. This is great. Something that's different in a 620 from the 560, which was a bit of a bugbear in the 560, was that the batteries were on the bottom. Now they're elevated, they're on a shelf here. These are all my cooking gear, fuel filter and everything. It's all raised off the ground now, so it stays perfectly dry in here. You can see you've got the underfloor. So there's nothing down there now, like in the 560, that you don't want getting wet. Everything's up on the floor. Even if I can just see, it comes up, but even the pump, so it's your bilge pump / line bait tank pump, and that is all raised now, so it's not sitting in water. Because no matter how good the hull is, you can get spray, so that now no longer have to worry about salt. Here's the other one. So there's my stove for tonight, and again, crank battery raised up. Plus, all this additional space on both sides. It's just ridiculous, the amount of space. If you told me you get this much space into a center console boat, I wouldn't believe you. And here she is. I love this. This is my live bait tank. Got the glass. You don't have to have the glass if you don't want to. There's some thongs in it at the moment, but that is a big tank. It's huge. And we're just working out a few teething problems with that. Instead of Perspex, just leaking a little bit, but I'll talk more on that in a sec. And then you've got a really big anchor well. You've got deck wash, which is fantastic. But that anchor well just doubles, you know, as a storage area as well. It's great. And I also have the Bonito bait board, which goes in there, one leg in there, another leg in there. I don't usually bring it out when I'm top water fishing because I want to be able to run around the boat, throw lures and stuff like that. But if I'm, say, float lining, snapper or what have you, I've got the missus out for a day, always throw it in because it's absolutely fantastic. So that is a bit of a walkthrough of the interior of the hull. So let's talk about ride. I can't describe how good the ride of this boat is. I fell in love with it the moment I got into it. It's just solid, it doesn't bang, it eats up chop. I've put some footage up, I'll put some again now, of the spray deflection. So one of the things I think that sort of does substantiate that to a degree is my first thoughts when I got this boat was I was going to do what I had in the 560 and get a set of clears all around the console here. That was, I said to the missus, I said to them, before we even put in the water, I've got to order some clears, put around that console. I'm at a stage where I think I probably don't even need it, but I still will get it. The reason behind that is when you're down south in the middle of June and July, middle of winter, and you're going snapper fishing, clears provide a big degree of warmth, so I'll get them for that reason. But while I'm up here and temperature's not a factor, neither is spray, so I don't have to worry about clears, which is great. And that's probably the first time I've ever said that about a center console, that I don't need clears. So space wise, let's talk about space, because I know a few couple of people, even Brad has mentioned, you know, she's pretty tight in here, and it is. But this boat is designed for island camping and Queensland style fishing, top water. So that's why we've got full walk around gunnels. We've got the big cast platform where you do all your top water fish up there. And then we've got storage. If I wanted to use this for game fishing back down south, I might go for the Express, because that's more set up to cater for game fishermen who want to fish out of the back of the boat the whole time. So it really is a matter of what you want to use the boat for. This, for my needs, absolutely perfect. It absolutely meets every requirement that I had when I was talking to Adam about what kind of boat I wanted and the type of fishing I was going to do, and also, you know, the long runs and the island camping. So absolutely perfect with that. So let's talk about economy. I have been averaging around 174 kilometers for 100 liters. I can sit on quite comfortably 33 knots at 5,000 revs. And it's got a 380 litre tank, like I said, which gives me a range of about 500 kilometres, probably a little bit more, but I try to be conservative with that, so about 500 k's on a tank. Top speed so far, I've got 43 knots. If you really want to be a rev head and do the runner from the cops and fisheries and maritime and everyone, then order the XT hull. It's like super reinforced. You can throw a 300 on the back of that, one of the new Mercs or something like that, and no one will catch you. Absolutely no one will catch you. But this for me is fast enough. I mean, yeah, when I'm lighter on fuel, it's just me in here. Yeah, I can, yeah, 40 knots, no dramas at all. 43 is my top speed, like I said, but I will, you know, I think my sweet spot for fuel conservation and speed is around that 30 knot mark. And given that up here in Queensland, you know, I'm doing a bit of reef fishing, so it's 120 kilometers before you get to even the first reef. So this boat is perfectly designed for that. So the other thing is flexibility. Adam and Greg are both great blokes, very approachable, and they will sit down and talk to you and listen to you about what your needs are when you're buying your boat. They took over the brand, I think, don't quote me on this, but 2 or 3 years ago, and it was languishing. Bonito boats were kind of languishing at that point, but they have really turned a corner with it, and they are on their way, I believe, to making it one of the best Australian boat brands in Australia. They're increasing their model range. The models that they're producing are just excellent. There's a couple of new ones on the way, a behemoth that, you know, makes the 660 look small. So there's plenty of big things coming out of the Bonito factory in the future. I think this hull is a great example of that. The innovation that a couple of Australian blokes have tried to bring to the market, and I think they've nailed a spot in terms of, you know, hull length. I think there's a bit of a hole there in that kind of, you know, 6 to 6.5 meter center console range at a very reasonable price point. The other thing is they're Australian blokes. They're making boats here in Australia. The factory's down the road down there at the Goldie. Adam's a young bloke and he's really entrepreneurial and he's really giving it his best. I mean, he just lives up the road from the Gold Coast. He should be down there chasing Instagram moles and stuff like that. Instead, he's in the factory day in, day out, producing quality boats. But don't let me tell you all about Adam. I did manage to grab him for a quick chat in between his busy schedule when I picked the boat up. So I'll just run a bit of that footage now with a bit of a chat with Adam. So Adam, mate, can you tell us a little bit about the construction process, particularly in respect to the 620, and then maybe we'll, if there's any differences in the other boats, but in this one in particular, because this is the one we were doing, the
620. So nothing had changed when we bought Bonito with the construction of the boats. We kept it the same. So
yep.
Fiberglass box section stringers, composite transoms, composite floors. So there's no timber in the boats at all.
So you don't have any rotting risk or anything like that.
No, yep. This boat will probably outlive us all. Yeah.
Yeah, it'll definitely outlive me. Yeah, maybe not you. You guys give it 10 years.
Yes, so you got a 10-year structural hull warranty on the boat. Yeah.
Okay.
Everything we do it heavy duty.
Yeah.
It's the ethos, yeah.
Yep.
So survey rated fuel tanks, everything's super clamped.
Yep.
everything's as good as we can possibly do it, yeah.
Yeah, because I remember with my 560, I mean, I certainly didn't look after that too well when I was out fishing in it, and it really took the punishment, and this feels just as solid, if not more. But people can go up to an XT-rated hull.
Yeah, so you can
go up to explain the difference with that one?
Yeah, so your XT-rated hull, you get more fiberglass, more structural glass
yep.
in the boat, so it's stronger.
Okay.
Yeah, it can handle the extra power.
Yeah,
extra
punishment.
Yeah.
So, like, for example, if this was the XT hull, you could put up to a 300 on this,
yeah, so you
could
put a 300 yep. on the back if you wanted to, yeah.
Okay, right. So for all the hoons out there, if you want to go that a little bit faster, a little bit meaner, go the XT. So for people that aren't looking for a center console, because I know Bonito boats do a lot of models with center console configuration, but you have hot off the press a...
Yeah, so we're working on an Express.
Yep.
As you would have seen, we've done the 660 and the big ram, so the half cabin.
Yep.
We're doing a 620 Express.
That's going to be a popular model, isn't it?
I hope so, fingers crossed.
But I mean, in terms of like Aussie fishing boats, and that this is the size point, which is pretty popular. But to offer them both a center console and a front drive version,
yeah,
you got to cover them, haven't you?
Yeah, so this will be a bit of a compromise between a half cabin and a runabout. So
yep.
you'll be able to sleep up the front, and you'll have the benefit of being relatively flat across the bow, so you'll be able to stand up there and cast.
We might have to get a Express too, yeah.
So you get most of the benefits of a center console at the same time as having a runabout.
Yeah. I mean, for me personally, I've always loved the center console. For a purely fishing platform, you really can't beat them. But yeah, if you want to go out and do some overnights, that Express could be right up your alley, couldn't
it? There are, yeah, should see really good economical fuel burn figures. And then big fuel tanks, so like 380 litres as you've got in your boat, which is massive. It's class beating.
But then, talk to me, like, some of the other benefits with buying Bonito is the ability to kind of build your boat to spec to a degree, hey?
Yes.
Like a lot of boats, they've got a fixed template, and that's what you get, you know, you pay your money, and that's what you get. But you can really build these boats
according to your needs. Experienced, like your cast platform, for example, is marginally longer, allowing you to sleep two people on it.
Everything I've got is always a bit longer.
Than a standard one. So it's all down to where you want things, how you want things done. Some boats, the consoles move forward, some will have them move slightly back.
Yeah.
Depends on how you fish, what you want. Yeah.
And then different types of seats, different types of T-tops,
console
size.
Everything's pretty universal with boats. That's the theory.
Yeah,
so
it's
literally a blank canvas for you to, you know, make what you want it to be. Yeah.
And I know that, like, sort of certainly throughout the build process on this boat, you know, Adam's just on the phone and you can kind of call him at any stage and he'll have chat to you about what your needs are and what you want and adapt it to suit, which is fantastic. To have that communication with your boat builder, I think, is critical. And mate, so a little bit about Bonito, the history. You've had it now for what, two and a half years?
2.5 years, actually, this month. Yeah, we've had it. So it's been a full on 2.5 years.
And I've got to, I have to ask a question. Like the Gold Coast, we're at Stieglitz, like southern Brisbane here. The Gold Coast is like, you can throw a rock and you're at the Gold Coast. And blokes your age, I mean, you should be down there, you know, chasing Instagram moles, running from the police, doing big lines of Billy Noak, yet you're here, you know, doing Gold Coast stuff, I suppose. But you're here building boats. Yeah, for a young bloke, very entrepreneurial, mate.
Yes, it's been a challenge. I love boats. Used to build Lego boats, so.
But just love boats?
Yeah, I love boats, yeah.
It's amazing.
I've been out in the water, yeah. It's good fun.
Yeah. And that, I think that's reflected in, since you guys have taken it over, like the range has increased.
When we took over, we had two models. And we've more than doubled that, I believe, nearly, in the last 2 years. And there's more coming. We aren't stopping yet.
For a boat manufacturer, really, in respect to the Australian market, you've got almost all of it covered, haven't you? You've got the big... If you bring out a 720, you've got the offshore brigade covered, haven't you? That's a game fishing rig, if ever there was one. But then you've got the little Tillisteer 500s if you want to go crabbing. I mean, there's perfect crabbing boat.
Pretty much everything, yeah.
Yeah,
no one's build out the range. We saw a lot of opportunity.
Yep.
With Bonito to grow the range and the models.
Yeah.
For all the different market segments, yeah.
Yep.
So aim to build the toughest, most solid sports fishing boat we possibly can in each size, which I believe we're doing.
And have you ever had any like come back with any damage really, like?
No.
Yeah, because I did try to break mine. In fact, if you watch a couple of episodes back there, if you follow the channel for a while, when I tried to kill the missus on the Willow Bar there in my 560, we were all busted up. The dog was almost gone, but the 560 held together, no worries.
Yeah, now we've had a couple of people smack their boats into some rocks and stuff, and they've driven home, so.
Yeah, no, they are great boats.
Yeah, no, you can't sink them.
Yeah, I've tried. We tried. We almost did it over the Willow Bar,
didn't we? So everything's fiberglass together, so nothing's screwed on any of our boats. Like, you'll notice when you go inside, like, all the cast platforms are all fiberglassed in, both sides, top and bottom.
Yep.
And then you'll see, like, even the consoles.
So for idiots like me, I don't know what you're talking about there. You're talking about where you join the deck to the hull.
Yeah, so anywhere there's a join, where you fiberglass it. Yeah.
So that just gives it added strength.
Utmost strength, yes.
Yep.
takes a bit of time. A lot of manufacturers won't do it just because of the time commitment. But it creates and a really strong, solid one piece of fiberglass boat.
Yeah, right. And if you follow Adam's channel, Bonito Boats, which I've always got the link under my videos there, guys, to have a look at that. But you'll see him doing things like standing on side pockets and things like that.
Yeah, I'll do all
climbing
that.
Into ice boxes and stuff like that.
Yes.
So they really are strong, tough boats.
Yeah, so I mean, I fish out of them. I know what they're like and how they work. And you want, you know, big macro boxes.
Because you personally got the big ram, haven't you?
That's your boat, the first half cabin big ram. Yeah. It's been awesome, like all our trips up the Fraser and off 1770 and off Mackay.
Yeah, it's a beautiful boat.
It's a beautiful boat. It does everything.
And that is a sister boat to the 660 center console. And also go back and have a look on Adam's channel there and see that big ram in action, you know, jumping waves. Morton Bay, was it?
Yeah,
he wasn't holding back. She was getting air, leaving the captain for dead, wasn't he?
Yeah, it's very fast.
Yeah.
The Bonito team's grown a lot. I'm still a vital part of it. Still on the factory floor.
Yeah.
Sanding and...
But you're actually getting in there.
Yeah, I do. I actually built
sleeves up. And, you're not just walking around cracking the whip anymore.
You can see I'm covered in.
Yeah. Okay. Well, that's very good.
Shirt on, but I'm covered in.
Yeah.
Fiberglass dust.
But so you're. But I guess the critical thing there is, in all seriousness, you're actually involved in every boat that's being built.
Yeah. So I have a touch in every part. Yeah. Every boat. Sorry, I see.
Yeah.
Whether I'm laminating part of it or helping assemble it or.
Yeah.
Doing the plug work to make the model, I've part in every part of it.
I think that's coming out in the finish, because the finish is just immaculate on these,
Yeah, that's coming on my...
That is beautiful.
I think that was the other thing too, like we do, I mean, actually using the boats and knowing what people want, or, you know, thinking you know what people want is like big screens, the ability to have big screens, a lot of the boats, you can't have big screens flush mounted. Whereas our boats, you can.
Yeah, and that actually is a good point. A bracket mounted sounder. I won't do that again after the walleye bar because that was caused all our problems. But also, even down to little things like, you know, Adam called me and asked where I wanted my screen placed on the console, and that made a world of difference. Instead of just shoving it in or having one designated area, we had that flexibility to put it where I wanted it. Fit a 16-inch screen on that console.
Boats are generally set up so you can actually fish out of them with plenty of tow holes everywhere. You can actually get access to all your stuff, like your batteries, with ease.
Yep.
They're not hidden away somewhere. They're up off the floor, hidden, you know, where they should be.
And I guess that is the beauty of like Bonito Boats, where you're located here. You've got a boat ramp just here.
You're testing these boats all the time, aren't you?
Yeah,
I get to test them, which is nice.
Yeah.
Not as much as I'd like, but I still get to test them.
That means fishing, testing. Okay, testing. Hey, that's great. Thank you very much for your time. More importantly, thank you for building this beautiful creature.
Can't wait to go fishing with you.
Yeah, we've got some good trips planned. Actually, we've got some big Bonito trips planned, so get your eye on the channel. You'll recall I spoke with Greg when we were out in the 660. We're going to do some mothershipping. We're going to go out to some exotic locations on the reef there. Plenty to come in the Bonito boats.
All right. You heard it from the man himself there, Adam, the guy who built the boat, and I'm the one who drives it, and I can safely say I love this boat. For me, it's perfect. I actually really can't find too many things to complain about. I think maybe the hatches might need a little bit of improvement, a little bit more Sikaflex around the glass on the live bait tank. I can't think of anything else, really. It really is perfect boat for my needs. And, you know, I've already put some good fish on the deck in it, and I think that sort of proves, you know, the versatility of this boat. Call Adam. Like I said, very approachable. He's happy to give you his time and talk you through your needs and what you're after. But Bonito Boats, watch this space. They have really, really turned a corner. Like I said, the brand's going to go places. I don't think you can find much better pricing for boats in the Australian market that are built by Australians and built. Is that a squid? One of those big bloody bullfed diamond mullets. Where was I? Yeah, you can't find better boats built here in Australia by Australian blokes for the price point. It really is fantastic. AMC on the Suzuki install. If you're looking at motors, especially Suzuki's, give them a bell. I think it's Rod there, but I'll put the details down below. They really did a great job on my boat and were really helpful. A lot of places will just put a motor on, sell it to you, and that's it. But their after-sale service was fantastic. So AMC, if you're looking at motors. Righto, I'm gonna go and finish setting up. Plans now, because this episode's not over, we just finished the review. Oh shit, hang on, T-top, how can I forget that? If you're ginger and you're outside in Queensland, you need one of these, T-top. This was really important to me because I had a custom built whiz bang T-top on the 560 and the thing absolutely shat itself and fell off. It was like a 1 ton fiberglass roof with piss weak bloody posts on it, and it was dreadful. I hated it, but this thing Adam does a deal with the guys at Relaxin, and they've installed this T-top, and it is bloody fantastic. First of all, it's nigh on waterproof. It's pretty good. It's lightweight. It's quite long, so it gives me full coverage from the sun, which I need. It comes with, you know, it's optional, but a matching rocket launcher. You want to got that, get that, which I did, because it's fantastic to have your rods up and away when you're in a center console. Graham, the bloke from Bonito, he put the lights in for me, like I said, he wired it all up. But with this T-top, it's absolutely fantastic. Something to think about if you're looking at the center console models at Bonito. But talk to Adam, because he can run you through it. And seat configuration, you don't have to have this. If you want to have a center console, but have more deck space, you can put in pedestal seats, you can put a lean-to, whatever you like. Like I said, really, really modular and accommodating. It's one thing I love about Bonito boats is every boat can be different. It can be built exactly the way you want it. Righto. That's enough of that. I hope you like it. I certainly do. Any questions, put it in the comments below. They'll send me a DM and I'll get back to you on the boat. Rightio, let's get organised. Don't have a fish.